Don't you just hate it when you're editing in DaVinci Resolve and you keep getting that menu? It is so annoying. Stop it. There we go. I think we got it now. Hey. Where'd it go? Well, at least it sounds like the audio is working. You know what? Maybe this will work. Ha ha. Got it. Now, don't actually do this at home. That's not gonna work. Okay, so in all seriousness, let's actually try to get your media back online. We're going to explore several different ways of what might cause that and how to fix it. But before we jump in there, please remember, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and now let's jump on in there and see how to do this. All right, so we're gonna get started here on the edit page. What you see here is actually, this is just a picture of media offline. I have not replicated every single issue, but I can help guide you through how to fix them. So this has been probably the most common thing people are dealing with in DaVinci Resolve 19. So why don't we start with one of the things that really appeared in DaVinci Resolve 19. First thing I want you to do is come up here to the top left and select DaVinci Resolve. Then we're going to come down and select Preferences. On preferences, you're probably going to come up here where it says memory, GPU, and system. I want you to come down to decode options. And if you look here under decode options, over here you're going to see decode H.264, H.265 using hardware acceleration. Now there may be an NVIDIA thing underneath of it, depends on your system. So if so, what you can do is go ahead and uncheck this box. You can save it and press OK. Now you may have to restart DaVinci Resolve, come back and see it. Now this typically does happen a lot with, say, like the cell phones and things like that. So that could possibly help. So once you get back, if it starts to work, then you can come back here again, go to DaVinci Resolve, go to Preferences, Decode Options, and let's check that box back on, press Save. And okay, and that could end up fixing the issue you're having, especially if you're using cell phone footage. You may get it where it like pops on and off like that, and that's really annoying. Okay, so other issues could be that your codec is not working for what your computer is. So you got to make sure everything is up to date. So definitely make sure your computer is up to date, plus make sure DaVinci Resolve is up to date. So an easy way to check to see if DaVinci Resolve is up to date is we're going to come back up here to that menu, DaVinci Resolve. We're going to come down to check for updates. DaVinci Resolve will automatically check the update and see if you are up to date properly. Other things that could possibly happen is you are uploading a video of a certain resolution, but you don't have the studio version, so it might not be supported due to that fact. So make sure that what you're uploading is going to match with what you are capable of editing with. You know, sometimes maybe what you've done was you went and selected a bunch of things that were all together like this, and then you created a compound clip. So we'll just call this one CPC compound clip test. Okay, so now once you've added that and then suddenly you have a media offline thing, you may have to just right click and then come down here to where it says decompose in place. Then you can go ahead and select this where it says using clips only. So what that'll do is then take that compound clip and put everything back to where its own clips are there, and then the media can relink to those clips. And that can actually solve most people's problems when it comes to media offline. Sometimes things happen with a compound clip or something if you have proxy medias and things like that. So that's why decompose in place, and it could possibly fix it as you go back to the original media. So you saw how to decompose a compound clip, but now we're gonna do the same thing with a timeline. As you can see, I already have all this edited. What we're gonna do is come up here to media pool. Then I'm gonna come down here, and as you can see, there's timeline is here. Normally I keep everything in folders nice and neat, but for this project, I wanted it to be a little bit chaotic so that way you could see how it might be in that way. Anyway, so what you wanna do is go ahead and find timeline. You're gonna right click on that and you're gonna come down here where it says create new timeline using selected clips. Okay, leave everything as it was. This way you don't make any changes and hit create. And now you just created there, but you see no edits. From here, we're going to do the same thing as what you saw with the compound clip. except it's with the new timeline. So let's right click that and find decompose in place, and then using clips only again. And now just like that, it's come back. And this could really solve a lot of people's issues as well. So make sure you give that a shot. Some of the problems could happen because of optimized media proxies and things like that. So if you're having these kinds of issues, one thing you can do is come back up to your playback. You can go to your render cache and see. Now you could have it set at none, but I always render my cache, select smart, and what that's going to do is render out my cache, and that's going to allow smoother playback and possibly eliminate some of this media offline. Next, you can come back up to that playback as well, and you can come down to manage render cache. Once you do that, you're going to want to come down here where it says location, and as you can see, this says local. But what I want to do is select all. And when it selects all, I can come over here to where it says render cache, select that, and then I can just go ahead and click this, and that's going to bring up everything onto its size. As you can see, this is zero. Let me select it again, and now it's going to bring it up there. And now you can see what size folders you have on your render cache, and if you need to, you go ahead and delete them. So find the project that you're on, select that. Say, for example, I'm on this one. So for example, say this one here is 56 gigabytes. It's not the one I'm working on, but you should do the one you're working on or any large ones, and go ahead and hit clear selected cache. And what that's going to do is delete all of those files and eliminate some of your problems. Some of the issue you could have is because your resolution might be too high for your computer. So what you can do is come up here to playback, and you can come down to timeline playback resolution, and you can lower this by half or quarter. And another thing that can cause a lot of problems and actually stop your renders and things like that, that may go along with this, and I suggest you do this anyway for all of these, is come up here to where it says DaVinci Resolve, select that, come down to your preferences like we did before, but this time we're going to come to the center part and we're going to select user. And here under user, once you do that, you're going to come down here and you're going to see this here. It's probably going to be selected. And this says stop renders when a frame or clip cannot be processed. That's going to cause a lot of problems. So I suggest right now you just go ahead, uncheck that, and save it. I'm just selecting cancel because I already had that. And now the most common thing that people have with is where their media is actually not linked. So what I want you to do is come up to your media pool, and I want you to take a look at your media and see whether or not anything says media offline, specifically here. And if so, if you take a look up here, you'll see this little chain icon. If the link is red, then that's showing that some media is actually offline. So now I'm going to replicate that issue because it's possible this is something you may have done. So I'm going to right click this. Since I can actually see mine, this will work. And I'm going to hit reveal in Finder. And what that's going to do is show me that I have my media here in this folder. So I know exactly where it is. That's where the source media is. Now, if for some reason you happened to take your media after already bringing it into DaVinci Resolve, renamed it, or moved it to another folder. So let me just create new folder. I'm just gonna name it test folder. Okay, so now I have it into a new folder. It's still in the original folder, but now it's been moved into another subfolder, which is going to cause DaVinci Resolve to unlink that. So now you see I have some that are done. Another thing that could happen is that you possibly disconnected your hard drive. So make sure all your connections are connected to the computer and everything is good. So now, how to relink this media very easily. What we're gonna do, and DaVinci Resolve is designed very well to make this a very simple process. What we're gonna do is we're gonna come back up to where I showed you that little link, and now you can see it's red, and we can see that it's offline in here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on that little relink media icon, and now this comes up, and it's saying two missing clips. And what I can do is two ways here. As you see, this is disk search. That's going to search the entire disk, and it's going to take a long time. But if you know where the file folder is that you were looking for, it makes it really easy. So let's go ahead and just select locate. And what it's going to do is bring up the menu, and you can go find where you have it. So I know that it was here in this edit SSD under my DaVinci Resolve libraries, And this is under Media Offline again. And now here is that folder, it's test folder. But I'm not gonna select that. I'm just going to select this one and allow DaVinci Resolve to run its process. And I'm just gonna select open. And it says two clips could not be found. Okay, so it didn't show it there. Now let's try by finding that folder that it is in, test folder. And now you can see it instantly relinked it. So I hope this has been helpful to you. And if you'd like to see more, go ahead and check one of these videos out here. And I'll see you in the next one.